From the time he stepped onto the ice in the NHL, Martin Brodeur was not your typical goalie. He was big, mobile, and was a threat with the puck.
This guy could move the puck as well as any defenseman. He's one of the few guys as a goaltender that could look the checker off so that he could make a nice easy pass up the middle.
He approached the game not like a traditional goalie. He was like a defenseman.
If the other team made a bad dump and we could see that he was going to get the puck, you would peel off to the side and get ready for a pass.
It was nice to have him be able to go out there and grab a puck and make that outlet pass.
I think the fact that I played the puck a lot, that really helped me out. Communication with my players, I think, for me was so important to stay engaged in the hockey game at all times.
They put a rule in for him, let's face it. The trapezoid is put in because of Marty Brodeur.
He just came in and just kind of took the lead by storm.
As a 21-year-old in the 1993-94 season, Martin Brodeur became a fixture in net for the New Jersey Devils, winning 27 games to earn the Calder Trophy as the league's top rookie. That season would end in heartbreak as the Devils lost in dramatic fashion to the New York Rangers in the Eastern Conference Final. However, in 1995, Brodeur and the Devils would reach the pinnacle of the hockey world, winning the franchise's first Stanley Cup.
For me, the first one, I'm always going to have some special bond. And everything happened so fast. You know, we went from a lockout to a 48-game season to the playoffs. And, you know, we haven't faced the Western Conference at all year. Next thing you know, we get to face one of the best teams in Detroit and, you know, turned around and we swept them in four.
Brodeur's remarkable play continued as he led the Devils to another Stanley Cup in 2000, and then a third in 2003.
He's one who I think makes his teammates in front of him extremely comfortable.
Kind of a breath of fresh air because he was a unique goalie that is just happy in the net.
There's no doubt in my mind he had a good time playing hockey.
I had fun. And I didn't want to put extra pressure on myself, so I felt like having fun and interacting on the ice, it was the best way of kind of relieving the pressure a little bit, and, you know, that's just the way I went about my business.
Yes! Brodeur scored a goal! Can you believe it?
Every time I got behind the microphone and I was doing a game with New Jersey and Marty, I couldn't wait because something was going to catch my attention. There was going to be something there that I left the game going, whoa, holy jumping, what a play that was, you know?
In his 22-season NHL career, Martin Brodeur created a legacy few can match. He made 9 All-Star Game appearances, won 4 Vezina trophies as the league's top goalie, and set the 2 most important career goaltending records in history, 125 shutouts and 691 wins.
And Marty Brodeur is the winningest goaltender in the NHL.
When I broke the record, I think just to see the joy in everybody around me, I know it meant a lot for everyone for me to get that because they were a part of my career. And you start from saying, well, I want to play one game in this league. I mean, this league is almost too high to be achievable. And next thing you know, you get there. And next thing you know, you get a little greedy. You just want more and more and more. And now that you look back, it's pretty impressive. And it was a great journey and it was a great ride.